Self-care is about so much more than eating healthy, working out, or doing a face mask. It's about doing what's best for you, both in the present and for your future self. So if you want to learn exactly what self-care really is, stay until the end of the video. Welcome back to my channel, guys. So to get this self-care Sunday started, the first thing I'm going to do is watching a webinar that I enrolled for. It's about how to create a full-time lifestyle business, even if you have no experience. And you may be wondering, what does this have to do with self-care, right? But it has everything to do, because I want to have my own business in the future and I want to live off of it. So for me, it's really important to do this for my future self, and I'm showing love to myself by doing it. And I already have here my notebook and pen to take notes of the webinar, and I also have my banana to eat while I watch it. Another misconception that people usually have about self-care is that it's always supposed to make you feel good. This is not always the case, because self-care can be really uncomfortable when you realize that you have to do the shadow work. You have to work on past trauma, and the best way to do it is through journaling. So I wrote down some of my favorite journal prompts to take care of yourself and do the shadow work, and I'm going to share them with you. So make sure you answer these 5 questions if you want to heal and grow. How do you think people see you? How would they describe you? How do you feel about that? What things are triggers for you? Consider where those irrational feelings stem from. When is the last time you felt let down? What person has hurt you the most in life? I suggest that you write them a letter telling them all the things you'd like to say. What most frightens you? How might you be able to expose yourself to that fear in a safe way? If you choose to get uncomfortable and answer these deep questions, you are going to know more about yourself and what you want for your future, and the past won't matter that much. Self-care is also about balance. Yes, it is important to eat healthy and nutritious foods for our body, but it's also important to listen to our cravings and allow ourselves to have them. I truly believe that balance is the key for a healthy and sustainable lifestyle, and that's why I had a salad for lunch with very nutritious foods, and now I'm having a bag of chips. You know, the thing is, I don't feel bad about it because I deserved it. So now let's watch some Netflix and eat our chips. For me, a big part of self-care also involves reading books, because there are so many books on self-development that really help you level up your life. So I'm gonna show you some of my favorites now. So this one is my favorite. It's The Secret about the Law of Attraction and Manifestation. Then we have Intuitive Living, which is a 6-week guide to self-love and reclaiming your mind-body connection. Then I also have The Success Principles by Jack Canfield. He's really well known, and this book is really worth it. Then The Power of Now, which is about spiritual enlightenment, and The 5 a.m. Club, which I really love. Another thing that I really like to do is listening to self-care and self-love podcasts on Spotify. I don't listen to them very often, but every time I do have time to do it, I try to listen to it because I find it really helpful. Especially this one that's called Mary's Cup of Tea Podcast, the self-love podcast for women. So definitely check this podcast if you have the time and want to improve your mental health and well-being.
And this is the podcast that'll inspire you to love yourself.
She speaks to her guests about all topics related to self-love, especially body image, body positivity, confidence, mental health, mindset, positivity, and so many others. And I just feel like it's so inspiring. So if you enjoyed this video and are ready to level up your life, don't forget to give me a massive thumbs up and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next Saturday. Bye!